Guys, Apple just dropped iOS 18.1, and it is loaded with smart upgrades that you do not want to miss out on. There's everything from advanced writing tools to tighten up your pros, to transforming your AirPods into hearing aids, and new ways to interact with everybody's favorite assistant. This update is all about enhancing your user experience with your iPhone, and if you're not sure where to start, I've got you because I'm covering 35 of the best updates coming to iOS 18.1. Let's get started. Apple Intelligence is here and it brings several notable features to the iPhone 15 Pro, 15 Pro Max, and all iPhone 16 devices. Apple's premier new feature is gonna be Writing Tools, which brings AI-powered assistance across all of your favorite apps. Now, Writing Tools enable you to first proofread and tighten up your text, rewrite text in different tones, could be personal or professional, summarize content into fewer words using key points, call to actions, lists, or into tables. And this also brings smart contextual replies directly into messages and mail, making communication all the more seamless. Now, it won't be until next month when we receive ChatGPT's integration with the writing tools, but make sure you get subscribed so you can see the very best features that are coming out in that update. Now, Apple Intelligence won't just help polish your pros, it's also gonna make all the information easier to digest and organize that you find on your iPhone. Building on Writing Tools, iOS 18.1 introduces powerful summarization features that go beyond just text, allowing you to extract the essence from websites, emails, and even audio recordings. Using Safari, websites can be distilled into a one-paragraph summary by clicking the Highlights button, which is going to be located at the left of the URL bar. Now, it's important to know that highlights aren't available in all regions or all countries, and Apple is determining if a summary is available by taking the website content and processing it on their side. Now, that doesn't make it insecure. This is actually all done via OHTTP, which is obfuscated HTTP, which is a network protocol used to enhance user privacy by obfuscating the relationship between the client, the phone, and on the servers. Next, you can get email summarizations inside of Apple's first-party mail app. To do so, open up Mail and tap in any message. There you'll see a summarize button in the top right-hand corner of the message. And you finally can summarize recorded audio in voice notes, recorded audio in notes, and recorded phone calls. Speaking of recorded calls, you can now record both traditional cellular and FaceTime audio calls with the new call recording button that's in the dialer app or the phone app. First, press the recording button in the phone menu while you're on a call. Now, after a countdown, both parties will hear a recorded message that the call is being recorded for legal reasons. Now, during the call, a new note is created letting you take notes and the system automatically transcribes the conversation once the call is complete. Now for Siri improvements, Apple is going just beyond helping you manage information, now making it easier to interact with your device anytime that you want to. Siri now features a sleek new glowing design around the device that looks beautiful anytime that you interact with it. It can carry on conversations without requiring you to reprompt it or by losing its place in your conversation. You can now choose to type or text to Siri based on whatever is going to be most convenient for you in that moment. And if you want to type, this is going to give you recommendations based on input by tapping the glyph. To do this, first you need to unlock your phone. Once your phone is unlocked, tap the bar at the bottom, which is normally for the reachability bar. You can go ahead and type your request, and if you want to get a request or get a recommendation, you can tap on the Siri glyph. Siri can also answer product knowledge related to questions related to Apple devices. Now, this does require a Wi-Fi connection or a cellular connection, but hopefully this is something that improves as future updates are made to make it available offline. I can see your Siri right now. She's looking at me. Oh, that's funny. Now, while Siri makes your interaction seamless, iOS 18.1 also transforms how you manage your photos. There are new ways and enhancements for photos to make it easier to find all those moments that are just that more meaningful and special. First, you can search photos using natural language, like find events that were in May of 2025, or hold holidays with family. Whatever you want to do, it's very much just using natural language that you use to describe anything. Now you can open up photos and tap the magnifying glass in the top right-hand corner. Next, search for whatever you want to. You could type in black cars, people smiling, memories with my son, whatever you want to. Next, you can create memories from text based on what you'd like to see. Go back to the main page of photos, scroll down to the bottom where it shows memories, tap on create, which is near the top right-hand corner of memories, and then describe exactly what you want to see. You get this really nice montage while the memory is being created, and then after a few seconds, you are presented with the memory itself. Then there's the cleanup tool, which is Apple's own first-party tool to remove distracting objects from photos using on-device machine learning to identify what those distracting items are. To do this, you open up any photo and select edit, tap the cleanup tool, which is shown as an eraser, You could run your finger over objects to remove them, or you could even pixelate objects or faces by just simply swiping over them. Now, I've had pretty good experience with removing objects, but like all object removal apps, when they fail pretty hard. If you've already been using an app like either Lightroom or something like that, let me know what it is and let me know how it compares to what you've been using in the comments below. iOS 18.1 brings an all new look to notification summaries, allowing you to select which apps are summarized and which app delivers full content. To adjust these settings, go into Settings, go to Notifications, and then Summarize Previews, and toggle on your preferred apps that you want to show or not show your summarizations. There's also a new Reduce Interruptions Focus Mode that is designed to help you manage notification interruption, hence the name, more effectively. This mode uses Apple Intelligence to prioritize important notifications and reduce unnecessary distractions. What's also great is that there is an Enable Intelligent Notification Breakthrough, which you can add in existing focus modes to ensure critical alerts always come through. iOS 18.1 puts essential settings at your fingertips with new Control Center updates. You can separate cellular Wi-Fi and Bluetooth controls into individual toggles. There's a new tap to cache via Apple Pay, which is available. And if you mess up and you take it too far, you can always reset Control Center, making it look like new. To do so, go to Settings, go to Control Center, and then go to Reset. New in iOS 18.1, AirPods Pro now doubles as hearing aids. Apple makes accessibility more personal. You can take a hearing test in the Health app. You can apply those recommendations to your AirPods Pro and wear them, making them just a little bit more affordable of a hearing aid. Now, I know someone who does suffer from hearing loss. I'm waiting for them to get 18.1 so I can hear it. So if you know anyone that is suffering from hearing loss, definitely suggest they actually try this. It's supposed to be pretty good. iOS 18.1 also empowers you to capture your world in brand new ways. First, you can take spatial photos with the iPhone 15 Pro and 15 Pro Max, up from being able to just take spatial videos. And second, with the iPhone 16 line of devices, you can use the camera control button, take selfies. Now, there's a number of miscellaneous features such as haptic feedback in calendar when swiping between days. You also get RCS business messages, which is enabled by your carrier. This allows businesses to send rich messages with additional information where it was only available previously with iMessage for Business. Now, that's going to wrap up our look at iOS 18.1. Let me know which feature you are most excited for down below. And do not forget to subscribe because I have a Control Center customization video coming out very soon. My name is Mike, and I will talk to you guys in the next one.